Yes! A pull request has been opened for that .NET MAUI bug that you've been waiting to get fixed, but did you know that you can test it out on your own project even before it gets merged? Let's go check it out. There are many cool things about open source projects. For one, you can see the full code base. You can see everything that is developed, how it's done, how people are doing it, how they're solving problems, and probably they're solving it just like you. So whenever you've read through that code base, you can take it to the next level and you can say, hey, I'm going to contribute to this project, because that is not as scary as you think it is. So build up that confidence and get to it. One of those cool open source projects is .NET MAUI, completely open source, has all that and much more. Now, maybe you're in the situation where you're like, oh, I hit this bug in .NET MAUI. We don't have that a lot, but you know, it happens. And you have a pull request that seems to solve the exact thing that you're waiting for. Now, what if I told you that you can pull down that fix, test it on your project with not too much effort, and verify the fix? And if you do, please let us know if it works or not, or what your considerations are. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to do just that. And please, if you decide to do it, report back to the issue, to the PR, that you've actually done it, what the results are, if it fixes it. Say thank you, that's always nice to do as well. But that will help us build confidence for the fix, for the PR, the pull request, that this is the actual right fix to do right here, right? So without further ado, let's just dive in and show you how to actually do this. So I'm just going to show you with a real world issue that is open on the .NET MAUI repository right now as I'm recording this. Actually, that is the reason why I'm recording this. I wanted to give some instructions to people like, hey, how can you pull down? How can you help us verify this bug? Well, the fix for this bug, actually. And I decided like, hey, why not turn it into a video? And then hopefully it will get some more reach and help you with other issues of your own as well. So this is an issue that's open right now. Hopefully it will be fixed soon. It will be closed soon because there is a PR open. We'll get to that in a little bit. But if you open an issue, please make sure to add as much detail as you can. So here is a nice description, really good. Unfortunately, initially, no reproduction project. That's always super helpful. If you want to learn more about why that's helpful, if you don't really see the value in that, please let me know down in the comments and I will make a video explaining that because it is super helpful. But we asked for it, like, hey, maybe it's an oversight, right? Maybe the author didn't think of it and we asked for it and he came through with a reproduction. So that's really great. But still, like, all the relevant log output, the full stack trace, also super, super helpful. But a reproduction always takes the cake, is super valuable. And here it is, here is a reproduction, and then some discussion after that, right? So I pulled down the reproduction. I have that here in my Visual Studio. Actually, let's go over it right now to just show you what's going on. So this is just a good reproduction is file new .NET MAUI project or whatever project you're going to look at, and then implement only the bits that are important to show the bug, to show the issue. So you're just going to take from your own project probably some bits and pieces with like, hey, doing that into your file new project. And then whenever you hit the bug, you're like, oh, this is all the moving parts that make up this bug. And that's why it's so important, because it also helps you understand like, oh, this is all the moving parts. So maybe it actually originates from here. So one, this helps you maybe find a workaround yourself. And two, maybe you realize by doing that, like, oh, I'm doing something in my code that maybe isn't correct, right? So very useful there. Already a little sneak peek on why a reproduction is good for you. Okay, so if I just run this on the Android emulator, because this bug is very specific to Android. It doesn't really matter what this bug is, but it has to do with like how many tabs there are shown in the tab bar down below. And whenever you click around in this reproduction, it's going to crash, right? So I know exactly what to do here. The app is going to come up right here. And then whenever you click on this login, logout tab right here, and you click on this button, it's going to throw an exception, right? Because something is going wrong. Doesn't really matter what the details is, you can see that this actually crashes. So we have that, and now we have a pull request for that. So that's really cool. Let me switch back to the browser real quick and show go to the second tab. And here we have a pull request by Kubaflow, who is on fire, who is someone in the community, Jacob. I've met him, he's a great guy, and he is putting out all kinds of pull requests, which is super cool. So thank you for doing that, Jacob, from this place. We super much appreciate all the work that you're doing for us. And he also opened a pull request for this specific issue. Now, He says like, hey, fixes this one, really great. And he adds videos for before and after. Also, videos, screen captures, always super valuable. So add that if you can. Then there's some discussion going on, et cetera, et cetera. We're triggering builds. We have some feedback because that's how it goes with pull requests. So that's really great. And then you come down here with the status. Now, if all status checks are done, it might be collapsed like this. So make sure that you like click on show all checks and it will come up with this overview right here. And what you want to do is search for this MAUI public one. It's a required one, and that's kind of like a top level check that only succeeds when there are like the other checks succeed, right? But during the build, because this is still building, that's how hot of the press this is, you can actually already go in and you can grab the artifacts if, of course, a certain part of the build is done. So click on details right here, and we get this overview page, and then you can click on view more details on Azure Pipelines. Now, this is on a public build server, so you can reach this as well. Not just people who are logged in, not just people at Microsoft, you can go here as well and see the actual build error. So if you are a contributor and you're like, oh, my build fails, why is that? You can go in here, you can see why it's going on here. But the most important thing, let me zoom in here a little bit, is right here. So you can see related, and it says 7 published, 2 consumed. And that's about the artifacts. So it has published already 7 artifacts, whatever that may be. There's a bunch of stuff that we need for dotnet MAUI. We consumed a couple of things. So that's all that. Let's just click that and see what happens. So you will get this list, hey, build macOS. So there's like logs and screenshots and whatever we put in there whenever we do a build. Logs, metadata, but we also have NuGets. And that's really cool. Because I'm logged in, I can expand this so I can see what's in here. If you're not logged in, you cannot see this. So that's kind of like the downside. There is some advantage to being logged in and being able to work with the system. But what you're still able to do, so you'll just see this and not the arrows. And you can go here to the 3 little dots at the end with the more actions. And you can say download artifacts. So let's just do that. It's going to take a little while because, you know, dotnet MAUI is a big thing. And it's going to download a zip file with all the files that you can see in here. So while this is actually downloading, let me just show you. This is what we're going to see. This is the exact contents that we will see in the zip file. And you can see that's all like the NuGet packages and the SNuGet packages, which is a separate thing for the symbols. Don't worry about that. But the new PKG, so NuPKG, that's kind of like the important thing here. And you can see like there's a ton, right? Like for the controls, for the web view, for the maps, for all the packages, all the NuGet packages that are associated with dotnet MAUI are in here. I think it downloaded by now. So let's go into the file explorer. And it's of course in my downloads folder. And you can see that I actually downloaded it before. So I have this NuGet one right now, and this NuGet is the exact same one. So I unzipped that, I decompressed it, and you can see it's in the NuGet folder right here. So I got that, and you can see the exact same files that you can see here in the background, right? So you can see all of that. And you don't really need to worry about all of this. The important part is kind of like this. It's kind of small, 8.0.60, which is the version number that we're going to use. So 8.0.60, and then some CI net da 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 da. That's a weird version number because it's a build from our CI build. Now that we've got that, we can install this from this local folder on your project. So let's switch back to Visual Studio. And actually, I have the CS Proj open here. So whenever you're in the Solution Explorer, you can go click on this solution on the project file, or you can right click and you can do like the edit project file in here, and you will land in this thing. And if you scroll down a little bit, you can now see in the newer dotnet MAUI templates. If not, you can just add this if you don't have it. You will see these package references. We are back partially to NuGet packages, and you can thus now install these NuGet packages from a CI build on your project to verify if this bug is fixed with this version. So now we have this microsoft.maui.controls. I'm not sure if we need the compatibility technically for this project, but that's fine. So this is again the reproduction project, and you can see the MAUI version is in here, and this means it will use the MAUI version that is inserted in the dotnet MAUI workload, which comes together with Visual Studio. So typically this should be fine. You shouldn't have to touch this. If you want the newer dotnet MAUI releases, they're out there on NuGet.org as well. They're a little bit ahead of the workloads that are out there. So if you don't want to wait, if you want to have like the newest updates for dotnet MAUI, but not wait for a new Visual Studio version, you can update the NuGets manually and see if there are some bug fixes in there or performance enhancements for you that are good to have. But what we can also do is use this local folder, this local NuGet, on your project. So to do that, if you've not set that up before, go to Tools, and then you will find the NuGet Package Manager and Package Manager Settings, right? And you will get to the settings dialog here, and we can go to Package Sources. Now, you can see all the sources that I have set up here, but also this local folder down here, which is pointing to a local folder. It's the C users, my username, downloads, NuGet. Right? That's the folder that we just saw. And you can just browse for another folder if you have it somewhere else, or you can add multiple of that which you want, and you can give it a little name, and it will show up right here. Perfect. Now we have a NuGet feed. As long as there's like new PKG files in there, it will pick it up, and you can install it either by manually specifying the version right here, or you can actually use the NuGet browser. So if I go back to the Solution Explorer, right-click on my project, and say Manage NuGet Packages, you will now see I have this package source called local folder together with all the rest. So I just want to make sure that I have this version, right? So I'm going to say local folder, and you can see it sees updates. I need to check the include pre-release box because of the weird version number that you can see here, 8.0.60, CI, net 8, yada, yada, yada. If there is like a string behind like the version, then it's going to see it as a pre-release. So make sure to check the pre-release checkbox right here. And now I can check these versions and I can install it. If you have like multiple NuGet packages inside of that folder, you can actually use this version dropdown right here. There's probably not anything here. Oh, actually there's 0.21, which it might pull down from somewhere else. Anyway, there might be multiple versions in here if you have like new, multiple NuGet packages in here, and you can just choose whatever you want and kind of like switch between them and see what the different bug fixes will do. I'm going to use this one, click update, actually update all of these. Then it's going to update these both packages. Yes, it's going to bring in like all the things. I've read all the agreements right here, and it's updated the packages. Go super fast because it's locally on my machine, so it should go pretty fast. If I go back to the CS project, you can see it now just replaced this with this version number right here. So let's just save this. It will do that automatically at build, but now we have it right here. Now, I have this NuGet package as part of my own project, and I can run this again on my Android emulator. It's going to build, it's going to deploy, and I can verify if this bug, by clicking around, is actually fixed, if it's not going to crash anymore. Here we are, the emulator is coming back up, so that must mean that we're almost deploying the application here, and then it's going to come back up, and just to show you, actually verify, it doesn't really matter if this works yes or no. I hope, of course, that it does. That will mean it fixed the bug, but still, like, that's probably a good thing to remember. Like, even although this kind of like fixes the exact crash, don't have a blind spot for that, if that's how you want to put it. Also make sure that the rest of your application still works, right? Like, the code base of .NET MAUI or any other project can be super complex, so whenever you're going to check that one thing, don't have tunnel vision. Like, yes, this works, but also check everything around it, right? Like, does the rest of the application still work as I expected as well, especially around like, hey, the area that you're clicking around right here. So make sure that if you have tests in place, of course you have that, right? Run the full test suite on this thing and report back to us, like I said, in the PR, in the issue with like, hey, I pulled down this version. Always make sure to mention the exact version number, not like the latest version or anything, because that might change. The exact version number, I pulled this version down. It worked on my project. Thank you so much, right? And that will give us a little bit more confidence, like, hey, this fixed it for this one person, 10 persons, 100 people, right? So make sure to report that back. Okay, so I clicked on this login, logout, I think, and then this button, and then it crashed, right? And now it's switching around some things, and it seems to work correctly. So it seems that this fix is correct. It seems correct. Still needs to go through the PR review, but at least we know that it fixed the main crash right here. And that's how you can verify these fixes from pull request on your own project. Now tell me that this is not super cool, because this is super, super cool. Your own project, a bug fix that's coming in, and you can verify it even before it's merged and you have to wait for the release. Now, of course, a word of caution, please do not go take these versions into production. Like, if you do it, that's on your own risk, but those versions are not supported by Microsoft. They are not like fully tested through all the whole pipeline and things. So you want to make sure that it's like really merged and in a release for that to happen, but this will at least verify you. And if you want to push it to production, that's kind of like on your own, but you know, please don't do that. Now, I've already mentioned it a couple of times. If you're kind of like opening an issue, provide all the details, add that stack trace, add the log output, and please provide that reproduction, right? It seems like a trivial thing, even if it's like file new .NET MAUI application, but start porting over all the things that are the moving parts of this issue, and you will get all kinds of insight yourself. And also, we don't have to do it. Like, you have everything on your screen. You have all the details. If we, as the .NET MAUI team, have to figure all that out, we're going to spend a lot of time trying to find your ways, trying to mind read a little bit, if you will. And that will cost us a lot of time while you have all that information available. And that will make the time to fix this actual issue a lot longer, because that's just time we don't really have to spend, right? We'd much rather have like a very much ready issue report where we're like, oh yes, this is exactly the place where I need to fix this, just fix it, and then we can roll it out, right? Instead of spending hours or days trying to figure out the reproduction ourselves, and then again, some time to actually fix the issue, right? So please provide that reproduction. Please let me know if you have like tried fixes, report back to the PR to the issue, if you've pulled down the version, and let us know the results, of course, and let me know what you think in the comments. Maybe this other video will help you more on your .NET MAUI journey, so be sure to check out that one as well, and I'll see you there.